So Here and Now, which is out this weekend on July the 4th, is a love story, an old-fashioned romance. It's about an inner-city girl who is dragged kicking and screaming on holiday with her parents to the countryside, and there she meets a quiet, reserved young country boy, and slowly, after some initial resistance on both their parts, they fall in love. I think the story originated in my mind when I actually first moved to the countryside. I lived in London for a long time. When I moved to the countryside, I suddenly became a father. All these things changed in my life, so I was interested in talking about some of those. And Here and Now is a kind of first love, a coming-of-age story. And if you want to look at things from a new perspective, that's a good medium to do it in. Grace, who's played by Lauren Johns, she did an amazing audition. She walked in, she had the attitude, she spoke in the right way, she carried herself like the character, so it was just one of those very easy casting calls on the spot. Andy Rush, who plays Say, is a great actor, and actually that as a role is quite a challenge because he doesn't speak a lot, so he has to express a lot of emotional intensity through his presence and his kind of physical characteristics, and Andy does that really well. It takes a certain maturity of an actor to be able to do that, and I think Andy pulled it off rather well. The cinematography is really important to the success of the film. I think we were really keen that the British countryside in all its lush greenness was almost an extra character. The changes in the landscape reflect the changes that the characters are experiencing in their life, and for that reason we shot at the turn of the season. So the film goes from the lush greens of an English and Welsh summer to the golds and the oranges of autumn. And you know, as the characters are growing up and coming of age themselves, so the seasons change. And I think that was that added an element to the film that it would have struggled without. The relationship between Say and Grace, I think, is something that everybody can emote with. I think it's what the first love in your life, the first time that you really find somebody else who understands you, is one of the first occasions that you really understand yourself. I think what that person sees in you makes you realise who you really are. And I think that's something that resonates with audiences, young and old. I think for me, the most poignant moment in the film is Say's revelation at the end about why, you know, talking about his father, and that's very close to an incident in my own life, so it's an autobiographical moment in the film for me, so it was very nice to write that out of my system and get it onto the screen and then let go of it. So for me, that's quite a poignant moment. I'd like to think that they found an escape in it. I think I'd like to think they found some time to think about, you know, how they're like those characters, and, you know, what in their life that they're maybe missing because they're not taking the time to pay attention to it. I love working in independent cinema, and I think that when you're pushed for time and money, which inevitably you are, it forces you to be really creative. You know, in order to shoot this film in the time period that we shot it, we had to come up with a whole visual language where we could reduce the number of shots. So literally we could get the film shot in time. And that meant that we looked at lots of old French movies, we looked at Japanese movies. We just found a way of using less shots and holding the frame for longer. And that gave the film a poetry of its own. You know, it gave it a rhythm of its own, which is quite meditative and thoughtful, and very different to contemporary fast-paced cutting. And I think that people like that. You know, it gives them some time to think during the film and to really look at the photography and to really emote with the characters. So that was a challenge, but I think it paid off. We've got several more projects in development already. You know, we're very keen to have something else ready to go as soon as Here and Now got on screen on July the 4th. So the next one is actually a contemporary reworking of a revenge western that we're hoping to shoot in Wales. And it's a great departure from the sunny romance of Here and Now. It's kind of gritty and bloody and quite scary. Our next film, Mal, which is definitely a great divergence from the kind of sunny love story that is Here and Now. I think as a filmmaker, you want to show the full range of what you can do and the full range of stories that you can tell. So having done love and romance this time, I was quite keen to do death and destruction next.